what is the best setup for Zoom if you're going to record a podcast or a video podcast? Let's face it, we've all been using Zoom for the last couple of years, and when recording a podcast, most of our guests are very familiar with the platform. But Zoom is not the best in terms of quality. In this video, I'm going to show you how to get the best out of Zoom in terms of audio and video. My name is Simon Banks. I am a video producer, and I've been producing a podcast for the last 2 years called The Humourology Show. And for the last 2 years, we have been using Zoom. And the main reason for this is our guests are very familiar with the platform, but it certainly is not the best when it comes to quality. So let me go through some steps on how we can maximize audio and video when it comes to using Zoom. Before we dive into the Zoom settings, there is one crucial element we need to talk about first, and that is our internet connection. Because without it, then this online recording is not going to happen. So I just want to go through some housekeeping on how we can get the best connection possible. So you might have heard something called a router or a router for our North American friends, and ideally, wherever you are in the household, you will be sitting fairly close to this sort of little black box. Now, if you can be what we call hardwired, from your router, at the back of it, there are some cables or some holes, which is, you can plug in what we call an Ethernet cable. They're not very expensive on Amazon, for example. And you should be able to plug them, maybe via a dongle, into your laptop or desktop. For the case like I have a very long cable which you can stretch from my router downstairs right onto my first floor. But the reason I want to be hardwired is because it's a much more reliable signal. It gives you much faster download and upload, and it's not subject to Wi-Fi, which, as we can all know, can actually drop out. And I've been recording for Zoom for 2 years, and I know Wi-Fi is one of our biggest issues. When it drops out, we just the audio goes and the video signal goes as well. There's an app here that I use, which you can just log in and it will test your speed, speedtest.net. And I'm sort of looking to see what your upload and download is. So ideally have an upload speed of greater than 20 meg. Hopefully if you're in a large city these days, that you should have a very good connection, much, much faster than that. But also the upload's really important as well. Also, the upload is really important as well, because obviously we're seeing your video, so we want something at least 5 meg or better. But the idea is, if we can get this as stable as possible, the better. If you're in a household while we're doing this recording, or any recording, ideally if you've got a teenager, maybe you might have to kick them off PS4 for a while. And also maybe not, if the rest of the family are watching Netflix movies, maybe you can ask them not to while we're doing the recording. So let's talk about audio devices. Now, if you're a guest, you're probably going to use your mic within your computer, whether it's laptop or desktop. Maybe you might have what we call a USB mic. That would be great if you could use that, just that the audio quality is so much better. This is what I'm using here at the moment. Or you can probably even use a pair of headsets if you've been on podcasts before. You often wear these. The good thing about these, A, it'll reduce any feedback you might get. Two, the mics on these is not too bad. So you might also have Apple AirPods here. I find these aren't so good. The microphone on these is absolutely awful. I don't know why, but it sounds like you're coming down a telephone line. They might be fine for just so you can listen to us, but ideally, don't use these as the microphone. Even your inbuilt mic on your computer or PC will be better. If you're being recorded in your home or an office, just be mindful that if there's other people around, you might need to close your doors or windows. So let's dive into the Zoom app, where we can look at optimizing our video and audio settings. So when you open up the Zoom app, if you go up to preferences, and on video, the first thing you want to do is actually set your camera. And I use quite a high-end camera here as my web camera, but you'll probably just default to what we call your inbuilt web camera if you have one. If not, we'll cover that in a moment, what to get. Basically, you want to make sure you click HD video here, and then I unclick touch up my appearance and adjust for low light. As tempting as it may be to highlight these, it will degrade the quality of the video. The rest of the the settings are really up to you. I have one here which is called hide non-video participants. You can do that because on the podcast I produce, I basically disappear, but you can still see my photograph. But if you don't want to see my image, you can click on that. But the important ones here are, let's look at the audio settings. First, you want to make sure that you select the right mic. I have a USB mic here that I'm using. I do have automatically adjust that you can. It does a fairly good job, but you might want to go to automatic and you can then select it yourself if you want. I basically suppress the audio, I just sort of make it audio. I don't want it too highly compressed, otherwise it will affect the sound. But the big one here, right here, is the music and professional audio. I want you to click this box. And ideally what we're looking for is we want to make sure we get the highest quality possible. And we want to make sure that echo cancellation is there, because that if you don't have headphones, that will possibly stop that sort of feedback we may get as well. We're not recording in stereo anyway, because it's just voice only. And the rest is basically preferences. So what does actually selecting professional music and audio mean? Generally means that Zoom will not compress the audio as much as possible. Now they do this purely just to save on bandwidth, but we want to make sure that we want to get the highest quality possible. But there's one more step that you have to do after selecting it in preferences. So when you actually in a meeting, when you start a meeting, well, you'll now see at the top left-hand side here, it says original sound. And you can select this on and off. So make sure that you select it on. So when you put your mic on, you'll be able to actually select which one your mic. I've got my USB mic, but you might have other options as well. So when this is on, this will tell Zoom not to compress the audio as much. So in an ideal world, we'll have a very stable internet connection and we've selected all the boxes to get the best video and quality from Zoom. But sometimes it doesn't all go to plan and the internet is been known to drop out. So in an ideal world, you can also record our recording on a smartphone. If you're using an iPhone like I have, you can just use Apple's Voice Memo. Just open the app when you hit record and just put the phone on the desk with these are the microphones pointing towards you. At the end of the show, just press stop and then you can either just email the file to the producer. You can either use Apple's Mail Drop or just transfer it to your machine and send it through something like WeTransfer. As we also record video for this podcast, you will be on camera. So let's talk about your webcam. So you or your guest will probably be using the webcam that came with your computer. And if it's a newish Mac or a PC, hopefully the webcam will be of decent quality. Now the only thing if you're using a laptop, as you can see, I'm looking down. We've all seen this effect on YouTube, and we're almost looking up people's noses. It's not a flattering look. So my big tip here is just raise the laptop onto some books so you can tilt the lid down. So ideally you have an eye level with the webcam here, which is normally the little black dot, which is right there. This is a lot more flattering eye line for you and your guest. My other tip for web cameras is occasionally clean it. They do get very dirty, and unless you want to have that sort of hazy fog-like look, I recommend just giving it a wipe with a soft cloth. So lighting is really important. We want to make sure that you and our guests look the best possible. So while it might be tempting to sit near a window with it behind you, ideally you'll be facing a window. Natural light is so much better and it's far more flattering. So one of the issues I have with Zoom is the quality of the video it records. By default, it only records at standard definition, which looks pretty awful when we're pretty used to watching our TVs in 4K or even what we call full HD. Now, you can't get full HD with Zoom unless you've got a business or enterprise account. But with a pro account, you can actually dig a little bit deeper. You're going to have to log into the actual app on a browser, and you can actually select what we call a high definition button. This will at least increase the resolution to 720p. If you log into your account on a browser, go into account management, account settings into meeting advanced. And if you come down here, it's got something called group HD video. By default, it's turned off. Just want you to turn it on and enable. The other thing to talk about here is virtual backgrounds. Yes, I know you can use them in Zoom, but for the highest quality, I prefer you don't use virtual backgrounds for your recording. So talking of backgrounds, make sure the real one behind you is neat and tidy, or at least you're happy with the way it is. One of the advantages of using Zoom is it allows you to record different video angles. To make sure that you get all the different angles, you're going to have to log in to your Zoom account on a browser, go to settings, go to recording. And what we're interested here is the cloud recording, because this actually allows you to record multiple angles. If you're just using the local recording, it won't allow you to do this. But if you record using the cloud feature, you can select what angles and what you want to record. So the main one here is this one here, record active speaker, gallery view and shared screen. I just actually click all these, even though ultimately I'm just really interested in the active speaker and the gallery view. I also tick record audio files only, record a separate file for each participant. This just means that if there's someone talking over each other, I can actually in post-production actually separate them out. Some advanced features here, I definitely unclick the add timestamp or the displayed participants' names in the recording. Don't need that, because I will do that in the post-production. I do tick this one here, which is optimized for third-party video editors, because I do edit and I happen to use Final Cut Pro. The others I'm not so interested in. The others are just options that you can have toggle on or off. So when you have these settings on, when you go back into Zoom, and if you actually start a new meeting, you just go to where it says record. Record to the cloud.
Recording in progress.
It'll give everyone that notice. And now it's recording in the cloud, and you'll know by this little cloud and the red dot flashing with recording. Once you finish, you stop recording.
Recording stopped.
And you'll be sent an email when the recordings are available, and you can download them from your Zoom account. And to retrieve them, you go back into your account via browser, go to recordings, and there they will be. And from here, you'll be able to download the speaker view, the gallery view, and any audio files that you have recorded. And one of the final steps is to make sure you turn off your notifications and quit any email program. To turn off notifications on a Mac, just go up to the top here, this little icon here. If you click on the Do Not Disturb, it will give you some options. Just an hour should be fine. This will stop any messages or emails that you might come through, which cause that annoying ping. Now, on a PC, I am sure there's a similar process in settings where you can turn notifications off. So thanks for watching. Leave in the comments below if any other tips or tricks that you have found useful when using Zoom. In the meantime, you might want to watch one of these videos. And I shall see you in the next video.